to my channel. I haven't done a video like this for a little while, so I thought I'd get one to you. I've just realised this is really dirty, so I wonder if it's probably gonna be dirty either way. It might not be exactly what you're expecting, I guess. Let's see what you think. So these are things that I do instead of going into debt. And what I mean by that is, you know, there is, at least for me, there are them times where I'm bored, I'm really wanting to go and spend some money, have some fun, go and get things that I'm expected to, go and be more materialistic, and kind of, I guess what I say all the time what not to do is, when I'm feeling like I want to keep up with the Joneses, when I'm wanting what the media tells me that I should be having, when I'm just feeling a bit restless, wanting to go traveling, wanting to have all the nice things, when life is kind of making me feel like I'm desiring more than what I have, and the only way that I would be able to get that is by going into debt. And these are things that I do so that I don't let my impulses take over. And I thought of a few things I have got into the habit of doing, to prevent that from happening. But my main piece of advice, or the main thing I actually do when I'm having those feelings, is I reflect upon what I'm consuming media wise and if I'm realizing I'm consuming a lot of negative media, and when I mean negative, I mean the type of media that encourages you to be more materialistic, to want more, to need more. When I'm feeling like that is driving me and what I'm mostly looking at, I cull it out completely and I actually switch and start to watch or listen to things that are in more of the realm of where I want to be. And a big thing that I watch is actually the Dave Ramsey podcast. Well, listen to. I listen to the Dave Ramsey podcast quite a lot, and that helps instill in me and remind me why I do not want to go into debt. And it sounds like a really bitchy thing, but listening to the phone calls on there, the ones that are really negative and the people that are in a ton of debt, it makes me realize I do not want that life. I do not want to ever go into debt. I do not want this to be a situation that I'm in. The thing that I'm wanting to buy, or the thing that I'm wanting, is not as important as how much I do not want to go into debt and be in that person's situation. Hearing them stories regularly really helps me go, this is why I'm living this lifestyle. This is why I don't have X, Y, and Z, because I don't want to be drowning in a ton of debt just to look good on the outside, or just to feel like I'm ticking a box, or just so that I have that feeling of I'm achieving because I have a new car or whatever. I can't think of an example. I'm not great at examples, but I listen to the Dave Ramsey podcast really religiously when I'm in that lull financially, I guess, because not only does it show me the negative side and how much I don't want X, Y, and Z, it also shows me the positive of, I'm living this lifestyle so that one day I can live like them. A thing that Dave Ramsey says all the time is, you live like no one else so that one day you can live and give like no one else. And it's really good to listen to that. And with anything in the world, take everything with a grain of salt. There are some parts that I don't necessarily agree with, and there are some parts that I really agree with. But that is the case with all media and anything. Always know your specific opinions so that you don't get taken in by other people's very strong opinions. But I find it really helpful listening to things like the Dave Ramsey podcast. And my second piece of advice, or thing that I do, is that kind of goes hand in hand with what listening to the Dave Ramsey podcast, or the more financial positive, like I've listened to a few of like Caleb Hammer's YouTube channel where he does the financial audit. I don't find that as palatable to watch, but still really helpful to watch and just kind of instill in me, this is why I'm living this lifestyle. But my other piece of advice that goes hand in hand is just unsubscribe. So if you have those Instagram accounts, those YouTube accounts that you follow, whatever it is, if you have emails that from shops, if you have things coming into your media outlet, so your emails, your YouTubes, your Instagrams, your TikToks, whatever it is, if the people in that are making you feel less than or not enough, or that you need this to be whole, you need to buy this, you need to have this, you need to spend all this money on this. If they're also having a lot of sponsorships that are very materialistic or that you need X, Y, and Z, unsubscribe. There has been times in my life where I really like a YouTube channel, but I've had to unsubscribe because of my life, current life events. Like when I did have my miscarriage a couple of years back when I lost a baby, I did unsubscribe to a few of the more of the like mummy YouTube channels because I just couldn't have that in my life right now. It was, someone was pregnant with their, like a few people at the time were pregnant with their fifth, sixth, seventh kids or whatever, and I was so heartbroken. And for that time being, I just needed to go, right, this is not good for me. It is not making me feel any better. And I just said, I'm gonna unsubscribe. I do the same if I feel like there is a YouTube channel or Instagram account that's making me feel like I need to have more or I need to go into debt or that I must have the next best thing. I just unsubscribe. Same with if I am getting emails from shops that are making me want to buy stuff and purchase things, I unsubscribe. That makes me want to keep up with the Joneses, then I completely curl out of my life. And the thing about unsubscribing is it doesn't have to be forever. So one YouTube channel that I have always loved, I've loved it since I can remember, since what I was, when my first baby, my 9-year-old was a baby, I used to watch it, was the Ellen Fisher YouTube channel. I still love her today, but when she had her fifth baby 2 years ago, she was due around the same time I was due my, what should have been my third baby that I lost. And I just had to, for about a year, I couldn't watch her videos. And then when I was healed, when I felt like I was able to go back to it, I went back and I actually rewatched all of the video, or I went and watched for the first time all the videos that I missed in that time. And I went from a different point of view, a healed point of view, and it made it so much easier. But it was a really hard thing for me to do because I just, it was like, if you watch something regularly, like I guess if you're so used to watching EastEnders and then suddenly you don't have that in your life, it's, oh, what do I do on a Thursday night? I don't know what nights EastEnders are on, I don't watch it. But that's what I did with a lot of YouTube channels. I had to just go, right, I can't have that in my life right now. It's not benefiting me. And that's what I would say to anyone, is really regularly, every 3 or 6 months, go through what you are taking in, what you are, what is the word I'm trying to say? The channels that you are watching, the things that you are reading, reflect on that. If you're watching a lot of the news and it's making you really anxious, stop reading the news. Very controversial thing, but I do not watch or read any news outlets whatsoever. I just don't do it. I don't feel like it benefits me a lot of the time because it just, there is more than nine times out of 10, absolutely nothing I can do about these situations. If there is, then great. But there isn't, realistically. My number three thing I kind of do when I'm feeling this way is, and when I'm wanting to go into debt because I want the next best thing, is I actually go through my budget and go, right, is my budget, look, am I struggling with this? Am I wanting to buy stuff because I've been too strict in my budget? Can I give myself some leeway? Can I make it so that I can spend a bit more money in certain areas? And the thing about a budget is people think they are controlling, but actually it is quite freedom. If you have, like, it gives you freedom. If you have the finances and you're not going into debt, like, you can chop and change your budget to suit you. So when I'm feeling this way, I go through our budget and I go, right, am I feeling like this because I'm restricting everything a bit too much? Can I give myself a bit of grace, a bit of enjoyment in life? So if you've watched any of my previous videos, you might know that now our food shopping budget used to be £400 a month. We have increased it to £500 a month because it was just getting too, we were getting too bogged down by having to stick to this budget when we didn't need to. We had room in the budget to increase it, which makes our day-to-day life more enjoyable, and we are less likely to drop the ball on the budget and go, screw it, we're gonna get a takeaway, say. It just makes you have more freedom, and it makes it easier to stick to a budget by doing things like this, by reflecting on it and changing it regularly. The next thing I do when I'm in this frame of mind of struggling and wanting to go into debt for fun is I plan as many free weekend activities over the next few weekends with friends or outside that are, like I said, free. I plan some games nights, some movie nights, going out for walks in really beautiful areas with friends and family. And the more stuff you can do outside, the more you can get out in nature, enjoy life with friends. It soon makes you realize how you don't need all of that stuff. If you take away the media, you take away the phones, you take away the TVs, you take away everything in your house where you're staring at things in your house and going, oh, I don't have this, oh, I want that. Go out into nature and you soon realize you don't need it all and you start to enjoy the day-to-day lives more. And if after doing this for a few weeks, you realize, no, I still really want that one item, then maybe it's time to reflect on that and go, actually, is it going to benefit my life? Should I actually look into buying that and saving up to be able to pay cash for that item or experience? But planning some free weekend activities with the whole family does make it go seem a lot easier to then realize, ah, I do enjoy my life. I don't need to go into debt. Another piece of advice that after I've gone through this list of what I've explained to you, I tend to then go through my house. I'm going to go through it and I'm going to organize and I'm going to declutter. And it's gonna make me grateful for the things I do have, realizing how much I do have. Also, if there are things that I'm able to declutter and I can sell, then the money that I make from selling them items, I can then decide to put that onto the object or activity that I've been wanting to do so that I can pay more and pay cash for it and not go into debt. But after spending a few weekends outside in nature or having friends around to play games or decluttering and listening to positive podcasts, unsubscribing from the negatives, it's really easy then for me to go, actually, I don't need all of these things, I am happy and I didn't need to go into debt. And then if after all of that, the things are still niggling at me and I go, actually, I'm still wanting this, I'm still wanting to do that, then I go, okay, now it's time to reflect on that and go, how much is this gonna cost? How much do I need it? How much do I want it? And how long is it going to take me to save for it? Is it still gonna be needed by that time? These are kind of the routines I've gotten into subconsciously, I guess now. By the end of doing everything I just explained, I tend to be in a better state mentally as well, because often when I'm having these desires to want more, to do more, to maybe go into debt to achieve these, I'm normally in a lot more of a negative mental state. And just by flipping everything around, getting outside, doing my little checklist, once my mental state improves, often all of the things that I thought I wanted or needed, I realize that's all they were. It was something I thought I wanted or needed, not something that I actually needed or wanted. And I am very happy and content with what I do have. That is everything, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video and I will hopefully see you in my next one. Let me know down below if there are any videos you would like to see and I will see you in my next video. Bye, friends.